I'm connected to my radio management PC through remote desktop, and I've got MNIS running, or at least the user interface running here. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to set MNIS up to work with radio management. So in this case, I've just got a single repeater, and I'm connected to this repeater through IP. So it's just a standard Ethernet cable going from the PC here to the repeater. The repeater has the NAI data license activated, and so I need to set up MNIS to talk to the radios through this repeater. So the first thing I need to do here is click on New. So this creates like a new configuration for MNIS. Since this is a single repeater operating in conventional mode, the obvious choice here would be to set a system operation mode to be conventional. Next, I need to specify a MNIS application ID. In this case, I'm going to be using 100. The MNIS tunnel IP I will leave as is. And let's go off onto security. Now, I'm not using any kind of encryption, enhanced, or basic privacy, so I will leave that as it is here. If you were going to be using any kind of privacy or encryption, you would need to add the keys in here. Next, onto the group list. Now, I don't want this MNIS to be receiving any kind of text messages or anything like that. I just want to do over-the-air programming. So this too I can leave out. There's nothing I need to set here. The same goes for a private list. I don't need to set anything here. Moving on to the conventional domain, I need to specify the IP address of the master repeater. So if you're going to be using just a single repeater and you want to be using over-the-air programming, even though this is not an IP site connect system, you still need to set that repeater up as a master repeater. And you need to give this repeater an IP address, in this case a static IP address, and you would set it up as if it was like just a single repeater IP site connect system. So in this case, the IP address of this repeater is 10.0.0.1. The UDP port of that repeater is 50,000. And then we're asked to give the MNIS link establishment port. You can choose automatically assigned, or you can pick a value. So I will just give this one, let's say 50,002. This is important because if this repeater is sitting behind a router, a NAT router, you would need to have a manual link establishment port assigned, and you would need to make sure that this port number is forwarded to the repeater. I'm not using authentication key. The repeater is not running ERDM or motor turbo link. I'm not using a private list. That's fine. Now we have two settings here, one for slot one and one for slot two. So basically, what you're telling MNIS to do here is whether it should consider data on slot one or slot two. So can MNIS use slot one or slot two or both? So in this case, I'm going to say both. Are either of these slots a revert channel? In my case, in this specific case, just a very, very simple setup. Both of them are not. I'm not using any encryption. MNIS is not part of any talk group, so I can leave that as none. We're not using enhanced GPS, at least in my setup, I'm not using enhanced GPS, so I can leave that also as is. There are settings here for capacity plus and link capacity plus. Since this is not neither a capacity plus or a link capacity plus or multi-site capacity plus system, I can leave those out. I do need to come down to advanced, and I need to look at some things here. So first, data core confirmed. I want to have that ticked, because what MNIS will do is when a radio sends data to MNIS, MNIS will send back an acknowledgement. Compressed UDP header, I'm not interested in. Battery saver preamble, yes, you want to have that enabled. What that will do is will tell MNIS, or at least the repeater, to like add on some preamble to bring the radios out of battery save if they are in battery save mode. Let's go on to network. So here are some settings here. The port numbers, the CHI network, the group CHI network, leave that as it is. What you want to maybe change here is the IP address of the DDMS server. Now, in this case, I have DDMS already installed and it's on the same PC as MNIS. So in this case, I should put here 127.0.0.1, and the port is obviously 3000. We can leave that as it is. Forwarding rules, I'm not going to use. I don't have any other applications running. I'm just using over-the-air programming using MNIS. Same goes for application override rules. That too I'm not using. Okay, so that completes the setup, but before I can start to use MNIS, I need to do two things. First, I need to save that all of these. I need to save it, so I'm just going to call it test 3. Okay, saved. Then the next thing I need to do is I need to go here and I need to say set it as a active configuration. Okay, so when MNIS starts, it will use the settings that we've put here. And then click on the play button here. That will start the service. Okay, and there are some things you can now go check in Windows. The first is we can go into the services, and if you scroll down, yeah, so there you can see Motor Turbo Network Interface Service, and you can see that it is running. The other thing that you can do is you can go to your command prompt and you can type in root print, and that gives you a listing of all the routes in the PC, and the ones that you're interested in are these three here. So these are the three routes that MNIS creates between the PC and the radio network. 12 is the IP address of the radio. 13, I believe, is the IP address of the Bluetooth connection on the radio. And I think 14 is the subnet that is used for the option board. I'm not 100% sure, but certainly the IP address of the radio will start with 12. The other route that you will have here is also this one here. This is the same as those three at the top here, except that this one is applicable to group-bound data. So data going to a group of radios or a specific talk group in the system. So there you can see that MNIS has been presumably correctly configured, and is running, and we have a route between the PC and the radio network.